And first thing in practice, how do you evaluate where you guys are now, where we can go?
I think we're more than anything else, we learned how to practice, you know, in terms of fighting through some of the bumps and bruises. I think more than anything else, understanding the difference between being hurt and being injured. You know, we've got some guys that, when you're injured, you got to be smart. But you're going to get banged up, and I think we've made progress in understanding how to practice, how to overcome a little bit of that, you know, double sessions, and I'm tired, and I'm sore. So I like the mentality from that standpoint. We're still trying to find ourselves relative to what our strengths and weaknesses are. But I think we're starting to focus in week two now on who we are. You know, this is who we're going to be. These are our perceived through week one, our strengths and our weaknesses, and that's what you get in week one. Now going to week two, you start to form who you are as a football team relative to those strengths and weaknesses.
Brian, did anybody jump out at you today that maybe was in the shadows before in a scrimmage situation?
You know, I'd say Tyler Eifert was outstanding today. You know, probably singularly offensively, he came in and showed that, he's really got the ability to be, more than just being in Kyle Rudolph's shadow. So he's a guy that we're going to have to find a way to get on the field. He matches up well, obviously, with his size. He gives us another weapon. I wouldn't be surprised to see both of those guys on the field at the same time. I thought he looked really good. Tommy Rees has done a really nice job. We'll have to decide where he is, but he's in hot competition to be, the number two. That's to be decided. But he did a nice job running the offense. Defensively, it starts with Manti and his ability to flow to the football, and we're doing a pretty good job defensively of getting after the football.
Strengths and weaknesses, kind of what you thought when we talked to you first a week ago.
On each side of the ball, first of all, I think we feel really comfortable with Theo at the Z. The slot position, he's inside, and Michael balancing off the tight end position on opposite sides of the field or together. So I think really the X position is really where those questions are still. Is it Duval? Is it TJ? Is it Shaq? Is it a combination of all three of those guys right now? I think that's really kind of where we're at relative to the offense. Dane Crist has clearly gotten better every day. He's improved his footwork, his just overall running our offense. At the end of the day, this whole conversation can be in a few words. Dane Crist is getting better every day. The rest of this other stuff, it's good, but it's really going to focus on Dane's ability, and the upshot is he's doing a nice job.
You were really impressed with TJ in the spring. Has that continued here in the fall?
Yeah, it's just, it's a little bit different now because, we've moved Duval over there, who's got a lot of experience. Shaq's a pretty good athlete. It's just more competition at that position than he had in the spring. In the spring, he didn't have much of the competition over there because we were trying to find out whether Shaq was a Z, and we had Duval at W, and now you got three guys over there. So it's just, he's going to play. I think all three of those guys are going to play. It just depends on how the thing shakes out at the end.
And given how you don't take the tight end off the field in your scheme, and given Kyle Rudolph's skill level, how valuable can he be to what you are trying to do here?
Well, his value is based upon the ability to have more than just Kyle Rudolph. We're going to be able to run the football. That's pretty clear after a week that we've got really solid backs. I think the big question mark I had with our running game in particular with Armando was, could he answer the bell every snap? And he's had a great camp. He's shown toughness. He's shown work volume. And so him with Sear Woods, who's maturing, we got a pretty good running game. That helps Kyle Rudolph. If you can run the football, Kyle Rudolph's going to be a better football player.
What about the backup defensive lineman? That was a concern going in. Has Sean Swinar, is he the number one guy off the bench?
Absolutely. At his position. He can't play the four technique. He can't play the five. He's playing inside. So if we kick the front and go even, he can play the one and the three. He can't play outside, or if we stay in our 30, he can play the nose. He's been really, really good. He's a solid football. Hafiz has done a nice job, and we got to get and continue to develop Emeka. He hasn't played a lot of football, you know, but those are your four guys right now that, you know, we're going to have to count on them playing winning football for us.
The offensive line has been in such a state of flux in the spring. Is that pretty much settled down, especially at the tackle position? It seems like Zach has been kind of a mainstay there.
Zach has been our most consistent. You know, so your left side, you know, right now is Stewart and Zach. Obviously, they're doing a great job. You know, Robinson's firmly ensconced at the right guard position. I think we're still battling at center and right tackle. But again, I think that those are pretty good battles. You know, Wenger and Cave are pretty good. Dever and Nuss are pretty good. So whoever wins it, you know, it's not going to be like, oh, you know we've got a pretty good starting five.
Did you see some things in the scrimmage today that you weren't able to see in the position drills, and what stands out?
Oh yeah, I mean, it's tackling more than anything else, you know. It's tackling, and then, you know, how you catch the ball in space. Do you make people miss? Are you an easy tackle? You know, I haven't talked about it, but, you know, Michael Floyd probably had his best day today, you know, and sometimes, you know, the best players get overlooked the easiest, you know, because you just expect that. But he probably had his best day today. So when you got Michael Floyd, you know, playing well for you as a one-on-one matchup guy, and you got Rudolph in there who wasn't in there, and you're running the football, that's a good day relative to balance on the offense.
When you had your first presser last week, you talked about how for the first time in a long time you wanted to get going. Mm-hmm. You're 3 weeks away from the first game. Do you wish you were there, or are you happy you have 3 weeks until that first game?
No, we need 3 weeks. You know, we've moved positively in the right direction, but you know, there's still a lot of questions about our football team that we've got to get answered. And I think one of them, you know, that I had a big question was three practices in a row, doubles yesterday, and then coming back with a full padded scrimmage today. I think I addressed it early on. You know, we're going to have some guys with owies, or we're going to have some guys that are come out here and keep competing, and we competed pretty good today.
Did Wenger and Romine participate?
No, they were not allowed. They did not. Our medical staff just looked at them, just didn't feel like, you know, they were ready to be moved any quicker.
Did anything serious happen to anybody today?
Not that I'm aware of. Jim would normally grab me during the practice, but my eye did not see anything that would, you know, cause me any concern at all.
Any sense on Rick Jones' return?
You know, I think we've left it up to him.
Okay.
You know, we want him to feel good, and he feels a lot better today. It's progression. We're only a week into it, so I don't think we're going to push it. I think he'll end up pushing it on his end a little bit more after the way you saw Eifert play today. I don't think I'm going to have to worry about that.
Did either offense or defense have the edge today?
No, I don't think so. I think there's, as I told our guys after, you know, it's never as good as you think. It's never as bad until you watch the film. I think if we had one thing that we wanted to do a little bit better defensively, is, you know, be consistent on the passing game. You know, we were able to throw the ball a little bit. I thought our defense did a pretty good job against the run. So, you know, it's one of those give-take situations.
Is the spot opposite Manti still kind of up for grabs?
Oh, yeah.
Is there some separation starting there?
That's going to be, you're right on it. I mean, that's a position we've got to get sorted out, that Will linebacker position. And the dog, you know, the drop position is still, we're not there yet. We really like where we're at, Mike. We really like our cat. We are who we are at the defensive line. I like our back end in terms of the depth that we can play with three corners up to four with Lowe now, the way he's playing, four safeties. It's really that Will and that drop position that a lot of our focus going into the second week will be on.
Is the cap Darius and
yes.
Perry?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yep.
Has Theo Riddick surprised you?
He's
just being new to the position, how far he's come?
I have high expectations for him. He's an elite player. He's just learning a position, but I think we'll be talking a lot about Theo Riddick as we move through the season.
Great. All right,
thank you.
Thank you, Coach.